Hello everyone. Good evening. This is Shreeja Santanam, your host for the day. I hope everyone is staying safe and keeping well. And first of all, thank you so much everyone for registering to today's speaker series. And let me use this opportunity to give you all a quick intro about DC CAP, the organization behind the speaker series. So DC CAP is a digital commerce agency helping businesses and brands abroad to create e-commerce storefronts. That said, during this challenging times, being in the lockdown, it's very much important for every one of us to hone our skills, to learn new things. To facilitate learning for our employees, as well as for the general community, DC CAP started hosting the speaker series, a virtual event that happens every Friday. Through the speaker series, we bring in distinguished thought leaders, technology masters, and change makers around the globe to address on varied topics which matters most to the community. All that said, I'm glad and proud of this special episode of speaker series dedicated to completely Magento. Being a Magento agency for more than a decade, we have a multitude of talented Magento evangelists within DC CAP. That said, I have brought in here a bunch of brightest Magento minds to talk about code quality, performance, and certification and whatnot. We have Jaikant, Magento U authorized trainer, Sri Vatsan, Magento certified solution specialist, Bharat, Magento certified full stack developer. The conversations between these three are moderated by Mohan Nadarajan, services practice leader and intrapreneur at DC CAP. Mohan comes with over 10 plus years of experience in Magento. He started his career not long ago as a Magento developer and quickly rose to a tremendous heights. Now he handles the entire Magento services team at DC CAP with over 100 plus developers, designers, and software engineers. Day in and day out, he is responsible for multiple accounts and clients pertaining to flawless delivery, account retention, forming, and client management. And last but not least, managing his humongous team. I hope you guys will have a great learning today. Should you have any question, feel free to raise your questions in the Q&A section that you can see at the bottom of your Zoom window. Without further ado, let me hand over the session to Mohan. Over to you, Mohan. Thank you.
Thank you, Shreeja, for the great introduction, right? And thank you everyone for joining the session with us today. And we have a great line of speakers. Instead of calling them as a speaker, and I could call, we have great TikTokers today on the discussion board, right? I'd like to introduce once again to my team. So we have Srivats here, Magento certified solution specialist. Hi, Srivats. Yeah, how are you, Srivats? Yeah.
I'm doing good, Mom.
Yeah, yeah. To talk more about Srivats, right? Srivats comes with around 10 plus years of experience, and he also started his career with Magento, and currently he's working with DC CAP associate architect. Before he's worked a couple of years with Infosys, and thank you for joining with us, Srivats. And so we have Bharat Vignesh, so senior software engineer at DC CAP. He's a Magento certified full stack developer. Hi, Bharat. I hope you're doing good. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. And so, yeah, we have Jaikant Rajan. Jaikant, so he comes with 4+ years of experience with Magento. So he's one of the certified, one of the association, Magento certificate association board member. He's also a Magento U authorized trainer. And so he has Magento certified professional and a front-end developer certification. And the good thing is that Jaikant is the one in India first completed the Magento professional certification. And many congratulations, Jaikant, for that. And hi, Jaikant. Yeah, how are you, Jaikant?
Hi, Mohan. I'm doing good. How are you?
And, yeah, I'm doing wonderful, Jaikant. And thank you for asking. And once again, welcome all and for joining with us. And today's session, right, we are going to cover about how to use the PHP Storm effectively for Magento development, and so how to do the performance testing and how to optimize the code for better performance. And we can also talk about certification and why you need to take a certification, because that's very important for Magento developers. Yeah, maybe I can start the question from Jaikant, right? So maybe Jaikant, right? Maybe you can talk more about that certification, right? Why do I need to take a certification?
Certifications are very important. I have a strategy like according to the Global Knowledge 2019 IT Skills and Salary Report, 85% of all IT professionals hold at least one certification. So certifications are a win-win to both you and your company. You gain a lot of knowledge when you are preparing for the certifications. If you take Magento, Magento is huge. As a developer, even though you work for several years, you cannot cover every single corner of Magento. It's literally huge. But when you're planning for attending the certification, you have to try and play around with every corners, every logics and everything. So that expands our learning. So I strongly recommend to take the certification, I mean, to everyone. And yeah, so basically it's a win-win for both.
Okay, Jikan. Yeah, thank you, Jikan. I totally got you right. Maybe as you mentioned about the certification, maybe we can go with Bharat, right? He's a full stack certified Magento developer. Many congratulations, Bharat, once again for that achievement, right? So can you please share your experience on this Magento full stack developer certification? How did you achieve and what are the steps involved to take this certification?
Sure, Mohan. Yeah. So the Magento certified full stack developer credential is a combination of three certifications. The first, Magento 2 Professional Developer Certification and the Magento 2 Certified Frontend Developer Certification and the Magento 2 Professional JavaScript Certification. So this is the combination behind the full stack badge. So about myself, how I got full stack, back in 2018, I took Magento 2 Professional Developer Certification and I got passed on that. And later on, back in 2019, I think June, I got Frontend Developer Certification. Back then, right, so it was there is nothing called a full stack badge. It was never introduced. And I think by September or November 2019, they have introduced this full stack credential. So by the time when they introduced, you know, basically I'm not a big fan of Magento JavaScript because I did not have much interest on how the Require.js and Knuckle.js is implemented on the front end. When this full stack badge is introduced, you know, I was really obsessed with the badge because if we have got a chance to look at the badge, you know, it was very different from the other badges. It may sound like funny, but it was seriously, I was obsessed with the badge, you know, the golden color and the crown they provided for that full stack badge. So I really thought of like, you know, I wanted to achieve that. So in order to achieve that, you know, I have to take the JavaScript certification. So, and I also have I have one of my friend who I met in Meet Magento Ahmedabad. So he also recently got a full stack developer certification. So he was also one of the motivation factor for me. I was inspired from him and I was ready to take up the JavaScript certification recently I want to be more precise, just the day before the COVID started in India, I completed the JavaScript certification and became a full stack. You know, after completing the full stack, I was badly waiting to see my name in the full stack dashboard. But, you know, due to COVID, everyone is working from home and I reached out to Adobe. Hey, you know, I can't see my name in the full stack, but I completed. You know, I'm seriously waiting to see my name over there, but I got a reply. Hey, you know, the server can be accessed only from the Adobe Office. Unfortunately, we can't do that only after the COVID ends. You know, the back and forth conversation was going on, but I don't know. Recently, I saw my name in the page. So yeah, this is the story behind the what motivated me to get the full stack badge.
That's great, Bharat. No, so even that Magento also motivates, right? So introducing some kind of this full stack development certification. I'm sure everyone is waiting for that badge. So that's why they are taking the certification. Yeah. So you mentioned, right, before that COVID starts, you taken the certification, right? I think right now it's very difficult. You know, people can't able to go out for their training for the Prometric centers to take the certification. I think Magento has option to take the certification as option to take from home by installing some softwares and by installing the webcam. So do you have experience on that, or else did you hear anyone try that kind of certification from home? We want to talk more about that because I think a couple of months back when we organized the Magento Master Series, I think a couple of people asked this question, hey, how do I take the certification from home?
Okay. Personally, I do not have experience taking the certification from home, but I have a friend of mine who recently got the certification from home. So I just got gathered some points from him, you know. Yeah, so it is similar. You need to register for the certification from the web accessor tool, Criterion, which is the current certification provider for the Magento U. I think all the community is aware, like from August 17th, Adobe is collaborating with Magento U. So until then, yeah, so this was a process. So you need to register over there. And once you need to at least register 1 week before your actual certification date. So once you've done that, you need to go to the web accessor portal. There you need to fulfill three steps. The first one is to install the Sentinel software. To install that software, you should have Windows 8 or Windows 10 OS. Then after installing the Sentinel OS, the second is to biometric verification. This biometric verification involves two steps. The one is the typing rhythm. So you may need to type your name or the other text that will be provided. They will be judging your typing speed and typing rhythm based on the AI. And the second thing is the facial recognition. They will capture your face just 1 week before the exam. So this is the pre-exam requirements. Then at the day of exam, you need to connect just after before, and you need to log in to your web accessor portal. And from there, you will see a launch button enable, and on clicking of launch, you will have additional test, like you need to disable all the firewalls, all the antiviruses in your laptop, and also like you need to disable or close all the Zoom or the like video conferencing tools. So these are some checks that will be taking just after before the exam. So once it is done, I think you can launch the exam. And so you know it is online proctor, right? So your proctor will be watching you all the time for all the whole 1.5 hours. So the main thing is like you need to have the webcam. The webcam is a proper webcam, not a mobile or not from PS4, not GoPro, not DSLR, proper webcam. So you need to have that, and you need to place it just right to your laptop so that both you and laptop will be covered. And also the environment, testing environment should be clean. The clean in sense, there should not be any electronic gadgets like mobile or TV like that. And also, yeah, so these are the basic things, and you should not read the questions aloud, because there is a possibility that, you know, we may record the questions, right? So you're not allowed to read the question aloud, and you must ask your families to stay out for this 1.5 hours from that particular room. So no one should enter the room. So these are the things. So if by chance, if something is, if you're not following these rules, yeah, pop-up will be coming. The exam will be closed, and the pop-up will be, saying like, hey, you are not fulfilling this thing. So fulfill like this. So these are the steps behind it. And I will also drop a good blog from Peter Martin from Magento U. So it covers all the what to do and what to expect on online quarter exam. I'll just drop it right now in the chat box. I hope it will be for the community.
Awesome, Bharat. Yeah, thank you so much for the insights about the taking the certification from home. I'm sure this will definitely helpful for the community who are all watching this session. And it's great that you also have a blog that you can share on the chat so that it helps for the people. Maybe we can move on to that some kind of technical discussion, right? I think in the agenda, we mentioned that we're going to talk more about that the PHP Storm and the performance improvement. Maybe I can move on to Streamers, iSewers. If you want to deliver a successful project, right, there are multiple stakeholders are involved, but the developers plays a major key role on the project delivery. So in your perspective, right, so what are the best practices that developers need to take for the successful delivery or the best code, right? Can you talk more about that?
Yeah, sure. First of all, good evening, and thank you for the introduction, Mohan and Srija. So I think, Mohan, this is a very valid question and also important question that we need to see how to deliver a successful quality and delivery. So from a developer perspective, so there are many many things that contribute to a successful delivery. From a developer perspective, developers take a few things when you start development for a Magento project. For example, when you start building things like modules or themes, we need to follow the coding standards. So Magento has got its own coding standards, which we need to follow. Even for example, languages like PHP or JavaScript has got its own language. PHP has got its PSR 1 and 2, and also the latest one being the PSR 12. On top of Magento is built on top of PHP, so Magento has got its own coding standard rules. These rules are well documented in DevDocs. You can refer to the Magento DevDocs and see what are the coding standards. There are a lot of coding standards and rules. So it is, for a developer, it is very difficult to remember all these rules. So this is where tools like PHP CodeSniffer, PHP MeshDetector helps us to keep track of our code quality. For example, PHP CodeSniffer detects the coding violations, and the PHP MeshDetector detects like potential bugs in your code, or cyclometric complexity, or unused parameters or objects, things that are not used in your code. So basically, these tools helps us to identify how bad or how inefficient our code, and also provide suggestions to how we can improve these tools are also free and open source. We can use it, download and use it. Again, Magento also provides the coding standard rules as part of the package. Earlier it used to be a separate package. Now I think from 2.4 it comes as part of the Magento package. It's like if you're using any IDEs to develop your Magento application, you can configure it once and use it for every time. I think PHP Storm is the closest IDE that supports Magento. Out of the box, we can configure these tools in the PHP Storm, and we can use it every time, right? So the next thing is like, what will happen if we follow a coding standards, right? So if you follow the coding standards, your code will be optimal. And one more advantage of using the coding standards is like, there is, once you develop the entire application, there is no need to you dedicate a separate time for code auditing or code optimization. All this will happen as part of your development process. So one advantage is you have a quality delivery, and other advantages like there is a effort and time is reduced. So these are the major advantages if we use the quality tools.
Yeah, so awesome, Srivats, right? So maybe you mentioned about the code snipper, right? PHP code snipper helps to validate your code, right? I'm not sure you can able to share the screen and explain more about that. Is it possible to show some kind of example how to validate the code?
Sure, Mohan. I think I can show you a sample code and how the code sniffer works. Yeah. So I hope everyone can see my screen.
Yes.
So this is a PHP Storm with a Magento 2.3. I've already configured my IDE with the code sniffer tools. I think installation, you can find it online. There are a lot of articles on how do you install all these code sniffer and configure. I'll just show you, I'll demonstrate how we can use that effectively. Right. So I have a function where I'll just type in a few lines of code. The code may not be relevant to what the work, but it's a sample code, and we'll see how it works. So yeah, this is again a sample code, but it does not solve any real world problems. I'll just demonstrate how the code sniffer works. So this is a sample piece of code that we write, and then I'll go to code, and then there is an option called inspect code in PHP Storm. It allows you to inspect your code. The inspection is going on. Yeah, you can see code sniffer tools validated and shown me the code violations in my code. Yeah, there are two errors. Yeah, here you can see it was expecting some statement which is not there, and yes, semicolon is missing in this line. So if I go, I can fix it here. It shows like there's something wrong, and these are syntax error. And it also like quality tools helps you to identify the warnings. Or here you can see. I can see that the braces has been opened in next line as part of the coding standards rules. It should be part of the same line. We also have a code beautifier tool which helps us automatically fix these things. So if I press this code beautifier, it will automatically fix this. Yeah, here you can see that the things has been changed. And I can show an example. You can see the text. Although I defined, I never used it. It is also highlighted that. And here you can see there are, it also shows that the result has been declared, variable has been declared, but we can combine this to single line. So that is what the PHP Storm is highlighting. So yeah, here you can see, I can avoid the duplicate variable or unused variable. And also one more example I can show is that you can see I've instantiated a few classes in the constructor. Here if I show like the qualifier can be imported on top as part of the use statement. Let's see, if you click on the balloon icon, it will show you how you can replace it with the import. Yeah, you can see that it is automatically converted to a use space. And yeah, likewise you can these tools will help you to automatically find the problems also automatically to some extent. These tools help us to fix those problems. I hope it.
Yeah, sure thing. This is definitely helpful, for the live demo, right? I'm sure everyone will get to understand how to use the PHP code sniffer. I think someone has asked the question, right? Sankalp Shekhar, right? So he asked how to configure the code sniffer.
I'll just give you a quick overview on how to configure it. So Magento comes with a Magento coding standard, a package that you can find in the Magento GitHub. You can use Composer to install it. And also you have the option in PHP Storm where you specifically go to settings and quality tools where you can configure your PHP code sniffer, PHP mesh detector path. Once you configure and validate, yeah, you can start using it.
Yeah. Thank you, Srivats. And Sankalp, right, if you still have any questions, maybe you can drop an email to community@dccap.com so that we'll send you the write up. And I think maybe we have a couple of other questions before moving to the next topic, right? I think someone has asked about, I think Deepak, he asked about the Magento certification preparation, right? I think it's a question for Bharat. So please share how you prepared for the certification he asked about.
Okay, how I prepared. So first of all, you need to have an experience, at least in 1 year of experience. So whatever the certification you're going to take. So for example, if I'm going to take a JavaScript certification, I need to have in my case, I have had a 3 to 4 months of experience working only in the Java checkout pages. The major thing is you should have experience. Then the second thing is you can go through the lot of guides are available. I would recommend SwiftWater. Joseph Maxwell had did a great job on doing those guides, so that would actually help. And the third thing is just go and have a look onto the dev docs. So dev docs will also be very helpful. You will find all the minute details on like deep dives, all the things over there. So once you have all these three things, you can take the SwiftWater examination just maybe 2 days before the exam. So if you get 80 plus on that exam, maybe, yeah, I think you're good to take the particular exam. So this same applies for all the three certifications. I just did follow the same. If you're going to take a professional developer certification and not completed associate yet, I would recommend you to take associate first, after then take professional developer certification. Because I have attended one of the sessions from Joseph Maxwell from Swiftwater, where he has mentioned around 80 to 90% of the community members have failed in the first attempt while taking the Java, while taking the professional developer certifications. You know, I also failed in my first attempt, you know. So take the associate developer first, because it will give you a rough idea on how to time manage and what to expect. And also you don't want to straight away risk your $290 or maybe yours or companies. So, and also if it will really give good exposure, and at the end of the day, you will also have the associate badge as well. So I hope I answered your question.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Bharat. Right. Also, when you talk about the preparing certification, I'm sure Jaykant has some experience, right? Since he's a Magento U authorized trainer, he's taking the Magento training across the globe. And so how did you handle at this time, Jaykant, because people are not able to travel to different places to take the training? So I'm sure there should be an option to take it and virtually. So do you have any, did you have any class, upcoming class for the virtual training?
Yes, Pavan, actually, everybody goes online these days due to the COVID situation. So training is no different. So we are online too. I mean, like using some Zoom or GoToMeeting. So instead of taking the classroom training, we are taking the virtual training. And the course structure, format, number of days, everything is exactly similar. So it's mostly practical. And so my schedule will be like, yes, I have a class and maybe in August or October, I'm not sure.
Okay, sure. No problem, Jaykant. Right. So we have another question, maybe it's for Bharat, right? So let's say if I take the certification from my home, right? So what happened, let's say if my network is failed or the power is shut down, so how can I restart, or is there any way to reach out the support team?
Yes. Yes, that's actually a very good question, and also a common question, you know. So in case of power failure, I would recommend you should have a necessary backup like UPS. You should have that, first thing. And in case like, you know, if something goes wrong with the Sentinel software, if the exam gets stuck, or in case you are seeing a blank page in the software, you know, in this case, you can just close that examination. And you can log into the web access portal, and there is a 24/7 support is there, and you can just ping them, and they will immediately respond back. And you can tell your problem, you know. So this is what I'm facing. So they will validate your request. So once it is confirmed, they will relaunch the exam. So again, you will see that particular launch button from your web access portal. From there, again, you can take the examination.
Yeah, thank you, Bharat. No, and thank you, Ranjit. That's a great question, right? It's useful for everyone. Thank you. And right, and we have a couple of other questions. Maybe before that, right? Maybe we can cover some of other topics, right? In the agenda, we mentioned about the performance optimization. That's very, very critical part of the Magento development. Maybe I can ask this question to Srivas, right? You have a great experience on optimizing various websites. So how do you first, before optimizing the performance, right? How do you test the performance, right? How to do the performance testing?
Yeah, that's a very valid question, an important question as well, Mohan. So the common problem that we face in Magento is slow. The performance is so slow. I think before we optimize any Magento site, we first need to know where to optimize. So for that, we need to understand where do I start a performance testing. So there are a lot of things that factors contribute to a performance of a web page. For example, it could be hardware, software, and network connections. So from a developer perspective, there are a few things that we can do to first identify the problem. So we use most popular tools that we can use is the GT Matrix, Google Page Insights, or web page tools. These tools can be a good starting point to test the page speed. You can pick any of the tools to analyze and follow the metrics. My suggestion is, like, if you're picking any tool, you stick with the tool till the very end of your optimization process, because these tools show a different set of results every time for the same page. So if you start comparing these metrics and start juggling these metrics, you lose track of the optimization. So long story short, if you're picking any of the tools, my suggestion is to stick with that tool till the very end. Right. So if you once you start testing, you will see the results. So the results will mostly contain a page score and a grade. And also the reports from all these performance tools website shows that how you can improve the performance. Like, you have a cache, you have a compression, enable proper compression, or have a CDN. So, but these are very generalized suggestions from these tools. So because these tools don't know what the application is, right? So they provide on a general perspective. But if you see the report, there is one key score we need to understand to optimize your page speed. That is the first byte time. So if you see, first byte time is will be graded between A to F. F means it is first byte time is very poor. A means, like, you have a very good first byte time. So I think from a developer perspective, we need to improvise the first byte time speed. So if you, basically first byte time, I can give you an example where you go and visit the homepage of a website. So once you hit the address in the address bar and it starts loading the website. So before you see the actual result, the amount of time that the server took to prepare that page. For example, if you take an example of Magento, there are a lot of blogs, there are a lot of layouts and a lot of observers that go happen in the background and before start rendering that page. So basically the first byte time is the request time or the waiting time that is of the client, in case this is a browser, to receive the first byte of information. So this basically is called what we call as a first byte time. If the first byte time is slow, there is a real chance, a real good chance that there is the underlying code is could be inefficient, or could be a lot of things happening in the background that we need to address. The report shows only that first byte time, there is a problem with the first byte time, but application like a Magento, we need to identify where exactly is the problem. So that is where we need a few set of tools to identify, to pinpoint where the problem is. So as part of the performance testing, we also need to have tools like a profiler. Profiler kind of show, profilers are built in Magento. There are also third-party profilers that helps you. You can configure and identify the problem. Blackfire is one of the popular tools to identify problems related to inefficient code. It is supported in Magento, and also it's nicely integrated with the Magento Cloud. It has got a lot of features, and one of the important features, like, you can compare the speed improvement before optimization and after optimization of the code. So this tool will help you time saver in identifying the problem. So again, it's a paid application. If you cannot afford, if you want to have some other tools, you can take a look at the default profiler that comes with the Magento, but that's not as advanced. That's very basic profiler. And we have better profilers available in the marketplace, which shows how much time the each block or each template is taking to load. Again, shows the slowest queries in the page, and shows, like, how many observers or how many events are running in the background. So these profilers will help you to identify or pinpoint exactly where is the problem. So again, there are a lot of profilers available in the market. And I think we also have our own profiler available in DC Cap Store, which we can also recommend if someone wants to take a look at and use it. So that is one part of the problem, right? So first, you identified where is the problem. Now we need to optimize the code. So I'll tell you a real-time example that I'll share my experience recently that I faced and doing a performance optimization. So I was working on a multi-site. It has got three websites in a single Magento instance, got a 40,000 products. The homepage was relatively standard, where you have a header, footer, and a few product sliders and homepage banner sliders. So the web page was unusually slow for the homepage. So when we think of Magento, when we think of multi-store, we generally think that, okay, I have a large set of catalog, which is around 40,000 products, and I also have multi-site. We generally assume that Magento is slow on the multi-site. However, when we started analyzing the performance, we found out that there is one section in the homepage that is causing the entire homepage to be slowed down. There was one third-party product slider that we used in the homepage where it pulled all the product attributes of each product. For example, I had around 50 attributes for a product. It pulled out all the 50 attributes and in the query and return in the MySQL query. So however, we used only four standard product attributes like name, image, price, and there's one attribute. So out of this, we don't need all the 50 attributes. So we optimized it by using the select query to load only the relevant fields that we use in the homepage. So one suggestion is that if you are loading a collection or a model or a custom loading data from a custom table, you filter and select only the fields that you wanted to use. Otherwise, the entire page gets slowed up. This is one example that I wanted to share.
Thank you, Srivats, on the great insight about how to do the performance testing, right? And I think maybe I can make this next question is open to everyone, right? Bharat, Archai, Kanta, Srivats, right? So maybe do you guys have any example, other example that you worked on the performance optimization? I implemented this thing and I got this result, right? So do you guys have any experience, real-time experience, want to share with the community?
Yeah, there is one question that is open in the chat that how do I optimize it in the front end UI and also like how we can optimize the checkout page. I think on the checkout page, does not have any cached. Mostly all of them are non-cached data. So there is very small chance of improving. So, but one recommendation from my experience is that if you're using any of the payment methods or any of the shipment methods that you are not using, for example, you don't use UPS or FedEx, you have turned it off in your Magento admin, but still it doesn't completely turn off the module. There are some parts of the code will open in the load in the checkout. So there, you can disable these modules completely in the code if you are not completely using that. So that will help you to optimize the checkout speeds.
Thank you, Srivats. Thank you, Pradeep, for the great question, right? If you still have any questions, maybe you can write an email to committee@dccap.com. We're happy to answer if you still need any explanation. Thank you. And now maybe over to you, Bharat, right? So do you have any experience on optimizing the performance in the recent days? So do you want to share anything?
Yes, sure, man. Definitely love to. And thanks, Srivas. And I think Srivas have covered almost all the optimization that is possible on the back end. But now I want to take to the front end. Okay, so before I start, right? So front end speed is directly proportional to the assets that you are loading, front end assets in the client, that is HTML, CSS, and the JavaScript. So there is already, Magento is already providing a very nice way to optimize those. Like minify HTML and minify CSS, but also merging CSS as well. And also they are providing some options, some native options from Magento. They are providing the minify, merge, and bundle the JavaScript files. You know, minify, I think all the community knows because it will uglify the JavaScript files, it will remove all the white spaces, you know. When comparing both the merge and bundle, you know, a merge will combine all the JavaScript files into a single one. It will be really bulky, and the bundle is like it will classify all the JavaScript files with the same size file. So it will actually range from 6 to 8 bundle files. Maybe I can quickly share my screen and I would like to show. I would like to walk through some of the DevDocs blog, which is really interesting about the advanced bundling concept, which I'm going to deep dive right now. So yeah, I would like to share my screen now. Okay, so there is one blog here regarding advanced JavaScript bundling. where are they after implementing this thing, you know, you will have a 3x performance improvement, where they have explained with the screenshot as well. I'm just walking through this thing and also deep diving into this particular blog and also the alternatives for this blog as well. So the first thing is like in the first screenshot. So this is how the native, you know, vanilla Magento looks like with the number of 100 plus JavaScript loading on all the pages, you know. So, and these are the two native options that is available. So one is a merging and one is a bundling. So when you bundle, right, so this is how the server request looks like. So 100 will be minified into, you know, just 12 over here. And all the JavaScript files are splitted into like in the bundle 0 to bundle 7. And the load time is 1 second, which is actually good. And it is actually really good when the browser catches these bundles. But it really frustrates, you know, it really hurts the customer experience on the first time when the customer visits. And the second screenshot mentioned about enabling both the merge and the bundle. And you can see all the JavaScript files. Let's say you have 1,000 JavaScript files used in the project and everything will be combined. And you can see the size. It's really huge. So 1.7 MB and speed is also okay, like 1 second. So the speed is actually really looking good just because it is in the developer environment, you know. But when it comes to the real world, right? So the speed will vary based on many parameters like the slow network and threshold collection, and also whenever if you are loading the website using mobile devices, right? So it will be it will load much slower when compared to the desktop. So in order to experiment this effort. So we are just throttling the speed with a slow 3G network. So when you do slow 3G network, the bundling speed will look like 44 seconds and the merging speed will look like 42 seconds. Okay, so merging is somewhat good when compared to the bundling. Okay, but our ultimate aim is to, I would like to pinpoint the problem with the bundling. So what is wrong? What is actually wrong with the native Magento bundling? So, okay, I'm in the homepage. So let's consider like a bundle 4, bundle 5, 6, and 7 have the JavaScript files that is only called and used in the maybe called like catalog pages or the checkout page. So I may need only this bundle 4 to bundle 7 files at the checkout page, not rather in the home page. But you know, all these files will be calling regardless of its usage. So if somewhere or other, if we can work around on these things, and if we can minimize, if we can eliminate this bundle 4 to bundle 7 JS in the home page, yeah, we will be ended up with some better performance improvement because we are reducing the request by 4, and also you can see almost like kind of 500 KB to 700 KB can be reduced. So, you know, the performance will be dramatically increased. So this is the ultimate aim for us. So this is a problem that we have. So this is the solution that Magento has provided. So that is called advanced bundling. So this is up to the developer or the client or the stakeholder, like what to bundle and where to call it. So you can, for the most common thing is you can bundle the JavaScripts based on the page types. In Magento, we have this page type called CMS, catalog, checkout, and shipping. So, and the cart and checkout, you know. So based on the page type, we can classify this JavaScript and you can bundle this JavaScript, and you can only call the, let's say, like a bundle cart.js file only in the cart page and bundle checkout.js file only in the checkout page. So it will be, and also there will be a lot of common JavaScript files that will be called in all the pages. So maybe you can find all those JavaScript files and you can bundle it and name it as common.js and call it in all the pages. So any particular page will have only the common.js file and the cms.js file if you are in the home page. So this is the ultimate aim. So this is called as advanced bundling. So how to implement advanced bundling and how to 3x your front end speed in native Magento. So you should have three tools. This is what Magento recommends: the Node.js, R.js, and the Phantom.js. And these are the configuration files that we'll be building through this experiment. The build.js file, it will have all the configurations, and the depth.js and the shell script file we have. So maybe you can have a look around it, like how it looks like. So now we need to create a build.js file. So how to create it? So this is a basic configuration, whether you want to minify it or not. If you want to minify, just name it as uglify2. So it will minify all the files. So this is, I know, so you want to manually add the value for these particular keys, dips, shims, and paths on map. You can find these values in the require.js in config.js file. So you can just open that file and you can see a lot of dip stacks will be there. It will be spread across that particular file, and you may see 15 to 20 dips tag and the shims tag on paths as well. So what you need to manually copy those things, and you need to manually add those JavaScript files over in the dips and shims. So this is one step. So once you're good with that step, we can move to the next step. We can add a modules tag and just define an empty array. Now we are going to pass a value for this modules tag, modules key. So now you need to fetch the JavaScript file based on the page types. So you can use phantom.js. No, Magento is using phantom.js, recommending phantom.js. You can just copy this script file and you can call it as dips.js. And what you need to, you know, the phantom.js will automatically enters the particular page and it waits for all the JavaScript file to load. So once it loads, it will just copy all the JavaScript files and it will just paste it in a text file. So this is how a normal phantom.js CLI command looks like. So phantom.js, you want to initiate phantom.js and dips.js where your script the script will be in place, and this is your homepage URL. And you need to copy all the JavaScript files called in the homepage to a homepage.txt file. So this applies for all the pages till checkout. Okay, so now we have all the JavaScript files in the text files. You know, now we need to identify what are the common JavaScript files that has been called in all the pages. You know, it involves a lot of manual effort. Before that, we need to to tweak a bit on this text file by removing the commas and removing the duplicate mixings. After that, you can use this command to identify the unique the common JavaScript file that has been used. I know this is a long process and it will be hard to follow, but I will share this link in the chat box. Maybe you can have a look after the meeting, after the series. Now you can use this dips.map.sh file. So this will identify how many what JavaScript files has been called in is common across the text files that we have. So we will end up with something look like this. Okay, we'll have the JavaScript file and we need to copy, let's say we have a catalog JavaScript. So you need to copy that JavaScript, all the JavaScript files, and you need to place it inside the modules empty array that we have declared in the build.js, and you need to name it as like bundles catalog, and it's same applies for the checkout bundles/checkout and bundles/VMS. Okay, so once it is done, you need to generate the bundles. To generate the bundle, this is where the require.js comes in place. It is order.js file. So once your build.js is ready, you need to deploy your system before that, and you need to rename your language locally, and you need to run this command. So it will generate the bundles. So once bundle is generated, you need to tell to Magento, hey, take my custom bundle, take my advanced bundle. So to do that, you need to have this particular JavaScript code at the end of your build.js file. Okay, once it is done, again, you need to redeploy. And once it is deployed, you can open your require.js config.js file, and you can see our bundle has been configured and its zipnet has been configured here. Once it is done, and you can just flash your cache and open your browser, and the results will be really amazing. Maybe I'm not sure whether you are seeing this. You can see the results is 22.76 seconds, without minifying. So once you minify, once you uglify, no, the results are really very good. So it's 16 seconds. Previously it was, 47. I think it comes around some 47 seconds. The speed will be three times faster than the native Magento bundling. So this is what advanced bundling concept looks like. So I hope I was clear and you could able to follow up with me. Okay, so you know, this is really hard, you know. It involves a lot of manual works. You need to create a text file, you need to manually copy and paste, you know. This is really difficult when it comes to the production, right? So you know, there is an another way. Andrew, so he's a contributor for Baylor. So Andrew has created one Chrome tool. Maybe I can, that will automate all this process. Maybe I can, just give me, I'm not sure why I can't open the tab. Okay. I'm just going for one Magento store. I would like to opt our Magento 2 marketplace. So I would like to open a normal window, not an import method. So okay, yeah. So there will be one. There is one tool available in the. It's not available in the Chrome store, but it is available in the GitHub. You need to configure. You need to study a bit to configure this. There is a blog over there. So yeah. So once you visit the Magento 2 store, there is one tab will be available. When I just want to confirm, am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible. Yeah.
Okay. Sure. You know. Once you visit the Magento 2 store, right, you just open this tab from your Chrome browser, go navigate to require.js and just click on the record button. No, it will automatically build the bundle file for you. I mean, the build.js file for you. Just you, all you need to do is just to navigate to the pages. Now I want to navigate to, a product listing page. Yes, you can see another bundle is created. No, 226 files has been called in the home page and still loading. No, I just want to pass here. No, you can. What you want to do is you, after installing this tool, you need to navigate to all the pages. You need to visit a product page, add the product to your cart, then visit to cart page and checkout page. So once you've done all those things, just stop the recording button and you will, and this Chrome tool will be preparing this build.js file, which is a major file which plays a major role in the advanced bundling concept. So you have this build.js file ready. You just need to copy and paste it in your root directory of the Magento. So this is how the final output looks like. Okay, so now what the problem with this particular tool, you know? It is easy when compared to the suggestion provided by the Magento. But you know, for example, in case you're applying it in the live and you already configured Jenkins and auto deployer tool, and you want to automate this process, you don't want to ask a developer to go and after enabling the live site and after that you need to go and visit all the pages to prepare the build.js file. You know, it is not really it will turn into a headache. So okay. So to overcome this, there is a one best tool that I have come across in the recent days. Just need to, I'm not sure why I can't open a new tab. Okay, again, I will open a new window. Okay, so manage pack, manage shoot, Magento 2, GitHub. Okay. So this is one tool which automate all the process, and auto has some very lot of positive sides. The tool which I showed right now in the Chrome tool, it has been dropped from the development some 2 years ago because Andrew is the one who is a contributor for the Baylor. So you know, Baylor is the next big thing in the Magento native bundling. Maybe you can they also, Magento also display a notice over here like the Magento Baylor. I think we are running out of time. Okay, I'll just quickly show this thing. Okay, I'll also share this link as well. Okay, so you just need to have your Node.js installed in your system. So once it is done, after the deployment, just run this command from your system. You need to pass your CMS URL and the category URL and the product URL. So make sure you enter the valid URL, because on installing the mesh pack suite, it will automatically install the headless Chromium, which will automatically add this particular product to the cart. It will navigate to the cart page and checkout page. It will do all the things automatically, and it will create one config.js file. And this config.js file will look something like this, which is also similar to a build.js file. So once it is prepared, you need to run another command, which is called a mesh pack bundle. Okay, once it is done, and you need to enable these bundling for the backend, and you just need to clean the cache, and the performance will be way much better. I also have a working proof. I just installed. Okay, not sure I have closed that. Okay, so this will also provide a very good results, almost a 3x of speed. I already implemented this in a couple of my projects. My client is really happy to see a much faster Magento front end. And also this MagePack MagSuite is also compatible with the native Magento features like the merging JavaScript and as well as the minifying JavaScript. And this also provides solves a series of pain points for the developer. It also provides, gives some major improvement in the Lighthouse testing from Google. Without bundling, the native Magento looks like 53 in the performance. Bundling with Baylor is 64, and bundling with MagePack, it goes 91. So it's a win-win for us. Both the speed will increase, and also the score in the score testing tool will see a great result on this. So I think that's all I have got on the advanced bundling one. Yeah.
Thank you so much, Bharat. It's very interesting. No, so you very well explained in detail about that advanced bundling. I think we ran out of time, so maybe or else we could have shown something else. Maybe we can have a separate session. No, if the people are interested on the advanced bundling, and also they asked a couple of questions, maybe we can discuss that offline. So maybe I can quickly jump on to Jaikant. I think Jaikant, you are working as a product lead at Chloris, right? Can you please talk more about Chloris, how Chloris can help to integrate between the two system, and how it helps for the performance thing?
So Chloris is basically a iPaaS product. Like, it's in between your systems. Like, if you want to integrate Magento with your ERP or CRM, for any system basically. So Chloris sits between that and listens for the data. We can also dynamically provide the data. So we basically get the data and pass the data to the respective systems. And the efficiency is good comparing other tools. Like we use AWS related stuff, a lot of that. Like for even dynamic calls, if you want to get dynamic prices, we are using AWS Lambda. So which uses a lot of servers to process the data, so which is much faster comparing if you want to explicitly make the call.
Great, Jikan. I think we have 1 minute left. Maybe quickly we can answer at least one question. We have many questions. Yeah,
sure. We'll go through that. So first, which is from Aniruddha. So is Rolik useful to improve optimization? So Rolik is not an optimization tool. It is a monitoring tool. It can provide you the information. So the page number, it can provide a lot of performance related information like page load time and your database queries, timings, everything. So we have to actively monitor that, and you should listen for the bottlenecks and something. So we have to find the different optimization technique, but Neuralink is a monitoring tool. So it helps you optimize. And you also asked for headless Magento optimization technique. So I don't understand what that means. Optimizing headless Magento or headless optimization. Okay, I'm leaving that. And Kinjal asked for small extension or demo for advanced JavaScript bundling. So I don't think we have time now anyway. So as Mohan told Bharat, you can also consider providing a different ask for the bundling, advanced bundling with our live demo. That helps too many, even I'm. Going on to Mahindra, so he asked how to put Pubfolder to EFS. So I personally never worked with Amazon EFS to store the files. Bharat or Srivat, have you worked on that? All right. Sorry, Mahindra, so none of us work with EFS. Maybe it's good to know here. We will give it a try later this session and see how that works. So finally, Kumar Shano asked for, is PHP Storm, is it any way to run deployment command as every time need to run in terminal? I don't know which terminal you're mentioning. There is an inbuilt terminal in PHP Storm. You can rely on that. Even it is, if it is very hard for you to type in the inline terminal, I think there is a way, but I never tried it personally. If you open your PHP Storm on the top right, you can find add configuration. And while adding the configuration, you can choose the template. Right there, you can choose some PHP built-in web server or something, PHP script. So in that, you can provide your command. I hope that helps.
Yeah, I think we ran out of time. It's already 7:01. And maybe we can end up the session, right? And thank you so much for everyone joining with us, right? We had a great session, and also we had a great question, right? It also asking the question is very good. It also helps for someone else. As many people asked about advanced bundling, maybe we can consider the advanced bundling in a separate session for the upcoming week. I'm sure Srija can set up another session for the upcoming weeks for the advanced bundling. And thank you so much once again, Bharat, Srivats, and Jaikant. And thank you so much, Srija, for organizing this session. Over to you, Srija.
Thank you, Mohan, and thank you guys for the wonderful session. So I could see like a lot of questions bombarding here and there. We ran out of time. So I'm sure like, no, we all meet you in another good event. And thank you, everyone. And thank you, Mohan, for the interviewing question. I hope like, so that benefited all the participants over here. And thank you guys. Have a great weekend. Yeah, bye-bye.
Thank you guys. So if you have any questions, if you have any feedback, please drop an email to community@dccamp.com. Thank you. Bye-bye.